Many of you that are in the blasphemous religion of Christianity or even other religions speak about unconditional love. In the fantasy world that you have conjured up in your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts, you esteem unconditional love as a superior type of love. The really crazy thing about your belief is that you are full of hypocrisy and that you do not even represent such a type of love in your own lives. You give your type of unconditional love only to that which is pleasing in your own eyes, and you spitefully mistreat others, including your children or your spouses, when they are not living in a way that is pleasing to what you desire. You measure everything with what pleases you, with absolutely no regard for what is pleasing before our Elohim's face. His righteous character is what is pleasing to him. Therefore, his righteous judgments are pleasing to him. His word tells us what his righteousness is before his face. His word tells us to purge out that which opposes his righteous judgments from our midst. He commanded us to purge out those who profane his Sabbaths from our midst. He commanded us to purge out the adulterers from our midst. He commanded us to purge out lying from our midst. He commanded us to purge out homosexuality and such from our midst. He commanded us to destroy all of the vain, meaningless worship to him and all of the idolatry and the idols from our midst. He commanded us to purge out all rebellion and the rest of his word from our midst as well. In doing so, he gave us his conditions in order for us to receive his love and his blessings. He said, if you will walk with me in my commandments, with my statutes and judgments, then I will be your Elohim and you will be my people. In your rebellious hearts, you speak about unconditional love as it being the type of love that our Creator has to his children. The truth is, you just desire to receive unconditional love from one another, including him. You offer up your syrupy, meaningless, vain, unconditional love to him, and you expect for him to send the same superficial type of love back to you. You agree to love him apart from his conditions, and you expect for him to remove his conditions that he gave to us to do in your doing so. But in your hypocrisy, you do not even offer up unconditional love to others. At best, some of you pretend to in your outward actions. For instance, you might manifest a degree of kindness or service to others who are not in agreement with that which is pleasing to your own eyes. But unconditional love is not what is in your hearts. Yahweh's word commands us to love one another in the same manner that we love ourselves. Within his definition of conditional love, we are to purge out that which will keep us from having eternal life awarded to us, not only in ourselves, but also in those whom we abide with. It is not our Creator's love to pat liars and hypocrites and snakes and vipers on the back as they skip merrily along the pathway that leads to the lake which burns with fire and brimstone. Our Messiah told us that we are supposed to let the dead bury their dead and to follow after him in his footsteps. He called the religious people of the day who served a vain image of his father snakes and vipers and liars and hypocrites. Most of you condemn me for doing the same. You write me and tell me that my doing so is evil, or you think that it is in your hearts. In doing so, you are calling good evil and evil good. Like the first witness, I was sent to bear witness to our Creator's word. Therefore, I was sent to bear witness against that which opposes his word. He sent me with fire coming out of my mouth against that which opposes his righteousness. And you have judged me, and you have condemned me for my doing so. You have judged me, and you condemn me for calling that which is evil what it is. You have judged me, and you have condemned me for calling unrighteous behavior what it is. Therefore, you have condemned our Creator's word. Your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts desire a silent witness who exhibits the unconditional love that your wicked hearts desire. You defend lies, yet you cast dust and stones at his anointed servant whom he has sent to tell you what is recorded in his scriptures of truth. Your error is, you have judged me with your own brand of righteousness and not with our Creator's righteousness that his word testifies to. This has been all quite incredible to witness. Our Messiah said that all will be judged by his Father's words in the last days. But instead of receiving this witness against you, you defend your rebellion to his word and you call his servant judgmental. I judge no man on my own merit, yet my judgment is true. Our Messiah spoke the same thing about his judging the religious of the day as snakes and vipers and liars and hypocrites. The judgment that Yahweh has sent me to you with is the judgment of his word. His righteous judgments are true, they are pure. They lead to pure love, and they condemn the unconditional love that nearly all of you, if not all of you, desire to receive from him and from others. You justify your selfishness and your other imperfections with comparing yourselves to others, or by hiding behind your belief that since no one is perfect, you and your imperfections are okay before our Elohim's face? Your error is, he bid us to learn to walk perfectly before his face. And so did his only begotten Son. In Matthew chapter 5, Yeshua commanded us to be perfect in the same manner that his Father is perfect. So your justifying your imperfections is plain shameful. And not only do you justify your imperfections, you have judged his messenger as being evil for his exposing your hypocrisy and your imperfections. The unconditional love that your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts desire is one-sided anyway. You desire to receive it, but apart from offering up your syrupy, meaningless, vain love to our Creator, you do not even offer it up to others. The type of love that you offer up to him certainly is not loving him within his terms and conditions. His Son said that if we love him, we will obey him. How is it obeying him? Therefore, how is it loving him to put yourselves and the things in your own lives or your own desires before his instructions? It is not. Your unconditional love that your hearts long to receive is full of selfishness and self-will. Like I said, some of you do put forth a superficial type of unconditional love on a physical plane toward those who are doing that which is pleasing in your own eyes. But your measurement for what is pleasing to you is not what is pleasing to the Most High. His desire is of no concern to your judgment. Most of you who do serve others do so in order to look good in your communities or to feel good about yourselves for doing good here and there anyway. You do so in order to whitewash your tombs, but inside you are nothing more than the dead before our Creator's face. You are dead people walking. You are zombies already clothed in your burial cloths. You can whitewash your burial clothes all that you would like, unless you are meeting the condition that our Creator has placed before us to be washed by his Son's shed blood. You are still clothed in your filthy garments before his face. His condition is you turn from deciding right from wrong for yourselves and hearken to that which he tells us is right and wrong before his face. His condition is that you turn from your rebellion to his word and that you turn to living his word in the flesh in order that your heart can become circumcised to become as he is. You need to throw away your false idolatries of your make-believe fantasy images of who he is. You need to realize that becoming his eternal children is conditional. You need to realize that the unconditional love that your wicked hearts desire is nothing more than the unconditional love of the dead. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.